The Narrow Road to the Deep North is the name of one of the most famous books in Japanese literature, written by the great haiku poet Basho in the 17th century. If that's one of the high points of Japanese culture, the building by the Imperial Japanese Army of what in Australia is known as the Death Railway in 1943 was one of its lowest points. The Death Railway was a 428-kilometre railway built over 8 months by between 250,000 and 300,000 slave labourers. Somewhere between 100,000 and 200,000 of them perished in the building of it. It was a crime against humanity, a terrible war crime. And my father was one of the survivors of that experience. He was one of the slave labourers as a captured Australian prisoner of war. I grew up, aware of two things about myself. One is that I wanted to be a writer, and the other great fact of my life was that I was, along with my brothers and sisters, a child of this death railway. And I never wished to write a novel about that experience, but at some point I realised I didn't have a choice. I came to realise that if I didn't write this book, I felt I would never probably write another book. It was like a stone that kept on growing inside me, and it was choking me. And I spent 12 years trying to write it. I wrote it as 5 different novels, not simply 5 different drafts, but 5 entirely different novels, different in story and characters, technique and so on. And each one was a failure. And then I realised that if I wished to write this story, it needed to be a story about love. And that is because if you wish to make art about darkness, you cannot only make something completely dark, because it's untrue to what we understand about ourselves as human beings. We are finally creatures of hope. The highest expression of hope is love, which is equally irrational and equally exists in a sphere beyond morality. When I was a child, my parents were very fond of telling this story about a Latvian migrant who'd ended up living in this little village where I was born in Tasmania. And this man had, when he'd lived in Europe during World War II, had been caught up in those great movements of people that affected the bloodlands of Eastern Europe. And he'd finally made it back to his village in Latvia at war's end, and it was to find the village razed to the ground, and his wife, he was told, had been killed. And he refused to believe this, and he searched that apocalyptic world of post-war Europe, searching for his wife in the displaced persons camps and the Red Cross refugee centres. And after 2 years, he had to admit that what he'd been told was the truth, and his wife was indeed dead. So he immigrated to Australia. He ended up in this little village where my family lived, and he married an Australian woman and had children. In 1957, he went to Sydney, which is the largest city in Australia, very far away from Tasmania, and he was walking down a street, a crowded street in the middle of Sydney, and he saw walking towards him his Latvian wife with a child on either hand. And he realised he had a few moments to make a choice about whether he acknowledged her or whether he walked on by. And growing up, I always thought that was the most beautiful story I knew about love, about its pain, its enduring nature, and the enormous costs we have to pay when we do love someone. And so I took that story and used that as the centrepiece for the novel about a character, an Australian doctor, who ends up commanding a group of Australian prisoners of war on the death railway, who comes to believe after the war that the woman he loves has died during the war, and then a quarter of a century later sees her walking towards him and realises that he was completely wrong about that, as he was about so many things. And the novel really spans 70 years, it has many characters, but it's really about the many forms of love. It's about family love, married love, erotic love, the brotherly love, the love of friends. When I was finishing writing the novel, I felt that perhaps in writing it, I would be able to divine all these things that more and more concerned me, tormented me even, these great questions of evil, death, love, goodness, wickedness, and so on. And I thought I might understand a little through the writing of the novel what these things were about, what they meant. And when I finished writing the novel, I realised I understood nothing at all. But I hoped I'd written something that other people might find some meaning in.